So if the children, what children we have, if they will come forward and collect the little green bill that we will have out, we will have a children's story.
Israelite men would come out and fight Goliath, and when that they would leave. And more than that, they would be their slaves. But if the Israelites lost, then they would have to surrender and be the slaves of the Philistines. So nothing had happened for 40 days. Now, why do you think that was? That nothing had happened? The giant Goliath would come out every day and he would taunt the Israelites. He would challenge them and laugh at them because they were afraid. But along with the story, David comes to the camp with the food and he finds out what's been going on. So he couldn't believe it. He says, "I'll go out and I'll fight that giant." Well, of course, everybody thought he was crazy. But he said, no. He says, "I'll fight the giant and I'll win because God is on my side. The God of Israel is on my side." So he went to the king and the king said, "All right, but you'll have to wear my armor." But guess what? The armor didn't fit because David was too small. He was just a kid. So he says, "I don't need that armor." He says, "I've got God on my side." So he went out on the battlefield the next day, and the giant was there, and he saw who was coming at him, and he started laughing. And he says, "I can't believe it. They're sending out a kid, a child, to fight me." He says, "So I guess I'll have to take you out, David." So as he approached David, David used a sling. He put the stone in the sling, and he started twirling it around his head. And when he released it, the stone hit the giant right in the forehead. The giant fell to his knees, and David ran over, grabbed his sword, and he killed the giant. Now, what does this story tell you about yourselves and life? Does it tell you that you can face any obstacle knowing that God is on your side? Does it? God is always on your side. And who is a good shepherd? Jesus is a good shepherd. And did you know that David, when he grew up, he became king of Israel? Isn't that a good story? All right, well, I have a Bible passage that, I don't know, Brianna, could you read it for us? Come over here. And the Bible passage comes from Matthew 25:23. Could you read that for us?
His Lord said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord."
Amen. Now, would any of you like to say a closing prayer? All right. Let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your good shepherd, Jesus, who looks after us. And Father, we ask you to bless these children in their lives now and forevermore. And Father, we ask you to be with us as we go on through this day, the Sabbath day, and we pray that we may give glory to you through your Son, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.